Let's take a look at a couple of ways in which you can save your project. This is similar to what I covered in the 2D conduction module, but those of you who have skipped directly to the CFD part, you wouldn't have seen this. If I go to the workbench window, I can say File, Save, and this should prompt. This should give throw up a window. In my case, already, I was playing around with this, so I already saved it. So to get that, window where I can select the file name, I'll say file. I'll select file save as, and go to an appropriate folder. I created a folder called Ansys Files, and I'll call this pipe underscore laminar. I like to use underscore rather than spaces in my file names because I was dragged kicking and screaming from Linux to Windows. Okay, and I can say enter. You won't get this. I'm getting this because I already, I was playing around with this and I have a file by the same name, so I'll just say replace it. And if you go to the folder where you saved it, you'll see it's created this WBPJ file. And also an associated folder, which is, the name of the project underscore files. And if I go into that folder, I see it has a bunch of stuff in here, which means that to retrieve the project, you need not only this WBPJ file, you also need this associated folder. And I've seen students tripping up because they've forgotten to save this folder. They think you just need the WBPJ file and you can, lose your work that way. There's another way to save it, which is often more convenient. So if I go back to the workbench window, I'll say File, Archive. And it'll save this in the WBPZ format. So I'll say Save. And again, it'll prompt me if I want to replace it. You won't get this. I'll say Yes. And here, I can say, whether I want to save results. And the reason to deselect that is it'll give you a much more compact file. It won't save the results of the velocity and pressure at the cell centers. And if you have a huge mesh, that'll save on space and you can email the small file. The colleague at the other end would have to regenerate the results, which is not hard to do. So in this case, I can leave that selected. Similarly for imported files, if you want to save on space, you can deselect that. I'll leave both of those selected here. And I'll say archive. And then if I go back to the folder, I will see this WBPZ file, which is about 41 kilobytes. And that's easy to, email and so on. And you can start this either by double-clicking on it. So you need just this one file, okay? So you can either save it as WBPJ and then you need this folder, or you can save it as WBPZ and just have this. And so you can double click on it to start up a WBPZ, or you in the project page, what you have to do is you have to say File, Restore Archive to read in a WBPZ, and then you can select the WBPZ. And then it'll ask you to save it in also, in the conventional format. So you can play around with those two ways of saving. And in our computer lab, for instance, students save the WBPZ onto a flash drive, and often they're running their project from the flash drive. We have fast computers in the simulation lab, and I've seen these simulations being very slow, and that's because they're running it from the flash drive. So it's a good practice to to copy your project into a folder or local folder, say on the desktop, run it from the desktop, and then once you're done, exit Ansys. And then copy the files back onto the flash drive rather than running from the flash drive.